About a month ago, we made a video about the possibility of alien life existing on Jupiter's moon Europa. Since then, subscribers have asked if we could make another video about the possibility of aliens roaming Saturn's biggest moon, Titan. Before we begin conjecturing about this fascinating topic, pause the video and let me know your thoughts in the comment section if you think there could be life on this obscure world. Due to its distance from the Sun, Titan is much colder than Earth. Its surface temperature is about negative 179 degrees Celsius. A mind-blowing implication due to this extreme cold is that if water ice is present, it won't melt, evaporate, or sublime. It will only remain in a solid form. Because Titan lacks liquid water on its surface, some scientists consider it is highly unlikely for life to exist there. On the other hand, its thick atmosphere is chemically active and rich in carbon compounds. On the surface, there are large lakes of liquid methane and ethane. And it is likely that there is a layer of liquid water under its ice shell. Some scientists speculate that these liquid mixes may provide prebiotic chemistry for living organisms. A possibility for the existence of liquid water on Titan's surface is that meteor strikes could create occasional impact oases craters where liquid water might persist for hundreds of years or even longer, which would enable water-based organic chemistry. Some laboratory simulations have led to the proposition that sufficient organic material exists on Titan to start a chemical evolution comparable to what is thought to have started life on Earth. The Miller-Urey experiment has shown that a thick, chemically active, rich in organic compound atmosphere, such as that of Titan, with the addition of ultraviolet radiation, can generate complex molecules and chemical precursors of life. In June 2010, scientists analyzing data from the Cassini-Huygens mission reported anomalies in the atmosphere near the surface of Titan, which could be consistent with the presence of methane-producing organisms. But the mission was not equipped to look directly for microorganisms, or to provide a thorough investigation of complex organic compounds. In October 2010, Sarah Horst of the University of Arizona reported finding the five nucleotide bases, the building blocks of DNA and RNA, among the many compounds produced when energy was applied to a combination of gases like those in Titan's atmosphere. Horst also found amino acids, the building blocks of protein. She said it was the first time nucleotide bases and amino acids had been found in such an experiment without liquid water being present. However, the lack of liquid water on the surface has led some scientists to question the prospect of finding life on Titan and justify the expense of a mission to look for it. Nevertheless, the planned Dragonfly rotorcraft mission is intended to land on solid ground. Dragonfly will carry equipment to study the chemical composition of Titan's surface and sample the lower atmosphere for possible biosignatures. If it will be able to find evidence for alien life, it will send shockwaves to our current understanding of the prevalence of life in the universe.